Good day. The state television company of Western Armenia represents all the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. A conference to the native Shushi took place in Republic of Western Armenia in Yerevan office. UNESCO is still working on sending a mission to Artsakh. Azerbaijan is again hindering. Armand Tatuyan, in an interview with his French counterpart, noted the need of return of Armenian captives from Azerbaijan. A new project in Artsakh dialect will be broadcast on Western Armenia TV every week. The Turkish Department of Western Armenia Radio will be broadcast soon. The fate of Mounties in occupied Western Armenia. Amazing result of joint Armenian-German excavations. Roman bridge voucher supply. A conference entitled to the native Shushi was held in Yerevan office of Western Armenia, the purpose of which was to bring together families deported from Shushi and adjacent communities under one roof, listen to their concerns and suggestions, organize a discussion as a result of which it will be possible to solve or contribute to all solutions of any problem. The president of Republic of Western Armenia, Armenak Abramyan, gave an introductory speech at a conference, greeted the attendees and talked about the importance of Shushi, especially for Western Armenia. Then historian Ashot Harutyunyan, military Norik Harutyunyan, and the Prime Minister of Western Armenia, Sedat Melikyan, made speeches. The meeting was held with strong emotion as a film about the city was shown, which at the same point led people to the happy reality that is already in the past. At the end of the meeting, the guests stated that they are ready to create a union dedicated to Shushi, which will be engaged in voicing and solving their problems. A year after the 44-day Artsakh War, the organization mission cannot visit Artsakh. UNESCO is still working in this direction. This was reported by Azerbaijan News Agency report in a press service of the organization. We are currently working on organizing this mission in Artsakh. We hope that this will be possible in the near future, but currently there are no necessary conditions. We are trying to get detailed information on this topic. This was reported by UNESCO. After the trilateral statement on the heads of Armenia, Azerbaijan and Russia on November 9, the Azerbaijani side is doing everything to prevent the access of UNESCO mission to Artsakh and its occupied territories. The UNESCO Minsk Group co-chairman countries also made statements about the need to preserve the Armenian cultural heritage and involve UNESCO in these works, which official Baku rejected, continuing to voice various accusations against the organization. Official Baku has been resorting to aggressive rhetoric in recent months, trying every possible way to make it impossible for the organization's mission to enter Artsakh. Armenian human rights defender Armand Tatuyan met with his French counterpart Claire Hanon in Paris. Armand Tatuyan in particular noted the need for the immediate return of Armenian captives from Azerbaijan. He also added that they are being held for political purposes, violating the rules of international law. The gross violation of the rights of Armenian servicemen and civilians by Azerbaijani armed units, including the issue of responsibility for torture and atrocities, were also touched upon separately. He also stressed that the Azerbaijani authorities spread a policy of hatred of Armenia and actively enmity against Armenians all over the world, keep the two peoples in tension, threaten the human rights system in other communities and maintain an atmosphere of tension. It is the consequence of this policy that there are torture and atrocities committed during and after the war. The television of Western Armenia will soon present to the viewer a TV program in Artsakh dialect. Preparatory work is currently underway. This initiative will become the basis for strengthening the idea of Artsakh as part of Western Armenia and strengthen the connection between Western Armenia and Artsakh. Dear compatriots, we are full of hope that we will be able to unite all of you around our true homeland, Western Armenia, in a cause of just restoration of the rights of which you can also take part with your effort and with a trace of devotion to our homeland. The opening of the Turkish Department of the Western Armenia radio station took place in Yerevan office of Western Armenia. Our Turkic-speaking compatriots living in Western Armenia and a Turkic-speaking society spread all over the world will henceforth have the opportunity, in addition to TV, they will be able to follow the news broadcast in Turkish on their radio channel. The radio channel will operate according to a 24-hour program through which listeners will be able to get acquainted with the news of Western Armenia, discuss issues directly related to Armenian music, Western Armenia, and their political analysis. As it is known, Western Armenia is a country of ancient peoples and civilizations. Armenians as an indigenous people and nation are essential elements of these lands. All peoples have left unforgettable traces on these lands despite all the destruction. At the beginning of 20th century, the experience of building a new nation based on one nation on the territory of Western Armenia was very painful and bloody. This program could not but affect cultural and religious structures. Armenia suffered the most from the destruction of cultural and religious values. Armenian churches, chapels, monasteries, and cemeteries have been destroyed, and now they continue to be destroyed. With the exceptions of Constantinople, very few Armenian historical and cultural values remain on the territory of Western Armenia today, and they have been preserved only for various purposes as a barn or a storage, etc. Read the full material on our official website. In the summer of 2019, Armenian and German researchers discovered an amazing thing with their spades. Huge slabs of Roman concrete were discovered at a depth of 30 centimeters from the surface of Ararat Valley. It is assumed that these slabs were hundreds of foundations of aqueduct, unfinished Roman pipeline designed to deliver water to the ancient city of Artashat. Although the original source of aqueduct is not exactly known, however, according to calculations, its length was about 31 kilometers, and perhaps it began at the Temple of Garni. We want to recall the fact that Rome controlled the ancient capital of Armenia, Artashat, for only 3 years. Then the Romans retreated to the west. The construction of aqueduct remained unfinished, and all traces of it eventually disappeared for centuries, remaining under a layer of earth and dust. Now the musical part, Ashuh Nazeli's song, Garmid Varti Alnem Sirum. The full version of this video is available on Western Armenia's YouTube channel. This was all for today. Goodbye.